virtual tour of the exhibition in the Valley of David and Goliath at the Bible Lands Museum, Jerusalem. I'm Amanda Weiss, and I'm very proud to open this exhibition for you today. You're going to see this exhibition in a light that most visitors never get to see, because you can spend as long as you want here exploring every detail, reading every fact, opening and zooming in on the artifacts in a way that only through this technology you have the capacity to do. This site dates to the time of King David. It's a very important archaeological site. It opens up an entire universe of information that we never were able to prove before. The Bible, archaeology, and the land of Israel come together in this site known today as Kirbet Kiapha. On display is evidence of the dating of the site through olive pits that were sent for carbon-14 dating, something that we all throw away today, was something that gave us actual scientific evidence to the 10th century BC, which is the time of King David, when this site existed and people lived here. Now, who lived here? That's a very good question, because we don't know 100%. There are a number of theories. Some people at the beginning claimed it must be a Philistine site because it's on the border between Judea and the Philistines. The Judeans and the Philistines come together in what is known as the Elah Valley here in Israel. As the Philistines were sea people and they came from the Mediterranean and took over, and they were very powerful, very aggressive and very powerful, and took over the region. The Judeans came from where we are here in Jerusalem, down from the mountains, and in the Elah Valley, that's where they met. It's where the Bible tells us that the battle between David and Goliath took place. So could this have been a Philistine city? Well, maybe, had we found pig bones. Yes, pig bones, because the Philistines were known to be great consumers of pork. Now, the Judeans are not. There's not one pig bone to be found in the kitchens that have been excavated here with their ovens and their stoves and their cooktops and their cooking ware and all this evidence that we have here, but no pig bones. Other animals as well, and you'll see that when you look at the site. What else do we know about? There is the find that is probably the most important piece here, and I recommend you take a good look at it. It's a cultic shrine model. It's a stone box, but it's carved in such a way, the details on it are so accurate and specific, it reflects the description in the Bible of the construction of the first temple. Now, this is obviously a very monumental and serious find. It is possibly one of the most important finds of this site, and arguably one of the most important finds to be discovered in Israel for decades. There's also writing. Writing that gives us a very interesting look into how people actually communicated and wrote with one another, and what language was in use, what type of writing and alphabetic, because it predates Hebrew as we know it. So all of these pieces and much more you're about to see, I'm not going to tell you about everything, but I'd like to take this opportunity to invite you to click on, open up, zoom in, read, see, and enjoy every element of this exhibition. We created it for you. Thank you very much. This site dates to the time of King David. It's a very important archaeological site. It opens up an entire universe of information that we never were able to prove before. The Bible, archaeology, and the land of Israel come together in this site known today as Kirbet Kiapha. On display is evidence of the dating of the site through olive pits that were sent for carbon-14 dating, something that we all throw away today, was something that gave us actual scientific evidence to the 10th century BC, which is the time of King David, when this site existed and people lived here. Now, who lived here? That's a very good question, because we don't know 100%. There are a number of theories. Some people at the beginning claimed it must be a Philistine site because it's on the border between Judea and the Philistines. The Judeans and the Philistines come together in what is known as the Elah Valley here in Israel. As the Philistines were sea people and they came from the Mediterranean and took over, and they were very powerful, very aggressive and very powerful, and took over the region. The Judeans came from where we are here in Jerusalem, down from the mountains, and in the Elah Valley, that's where they met. It's where the Bible tells us that the battle between David and Goliath took place. So could this have been a Philistine city? Well, maybe, had we found pig bones. Yes, pig bones. Because the Philistines were known to be great consumers of pork. Now, the Judeans are not. There's not one pig bone to be found in the kitchens that have been excavated here with their ovens and their stoves and their cooktops and their cooking ware and all this evidence that we have here. But no pig bones. Other animals as well, and you'll see that when you look at the site. What else do we know about? There is the find that is probably the most important piece here, and I recommend you take a good look at it. It's a cultic shrine model. It's a stone box, but it's carved in such a way, the details on it are so accurate and specific, it reflects the description in the Bible of the construction of the first temple. Now, this is obviously a very monumental and serious find. It is possibly one of the most important finds of this site, and arguably one of the most important finds to be discovered in Israel for decades. There's also writing. Writing that gives us a very interesting look into how people actually communicated and wrote with one another, and what language was in use, what type of writing and alphabetic, because